But when you did Christopher Robin, and what was it, 2019? Something like that. Anyway, I want to know your thoughts on the redesigns for Pooh and Tigger and Company, because I've always told my friends the reason that movie works is because Jim Cummings has given the performance of his life for these characters. That was Oscar worthy. I'm sorry to Leo and his bear incident, but
the bear incident. I don't know what that.
The Revenant.
Oh yeah. Well, I don't know.
But that bear needed an Oscar.
That was a different bear.
Yeah.
No. That bear didn't like. I mean, he wasn't fooling anyone.
But like, what was your thoughts?
No. Yeah. Well, thanks. You know, that's very kind of you. That's Time Magazine wrote an article about it, said that I should be nominated. I thought they were right. But I don't have to be nominated, but forget about it. But that's kind of you, yeah. Everybody really got a kick out of that. And I think it was just so heartfelt. You know? It really tugged at your heartstrings. You know? I mean, I knew what was going to happen. I teared up. So I'm glad you enjoyed it. And yes, I did steal. I was over at Disney and we're doing a photo shoot there. These are ones that were used in the movie. Really? Good. That's no, we need those back. Jim?
Did the You sung the opening cutscene for Crash Bandicoot for PS1, which is unused. I don't know if this is familiar.
Well, that does sound like me. How did you find that, man?
YouTube.
Amen. Hi, my name is, yes I am, my name is Joe. You may remember me as Sherlock Holmes from Nashville's Wizard World back in September 2015. My favorite dessert, I'm going to say chocolate brownies, and as for a maniacal laugh,
yes.
School's out for
school's been blown to pieces. My question for you.
Okay, that's all. Thank you. What's up, brother?
My question is there a particular cartoon you grew up with that you might still enjoy, or any favorite cartoon character that maybe you didn't voice yourself?
Oh, well, yeah, geez. You know, when I was a kid, I dug Mighty Mouse. That was a cool one. Here I come to save the day. I thought that was cool. And, Rocky and Bullwinkle. You know, all the Looney Tunes, you know, they still stand up. You know. I used to like the ones that were very old, and they would tend to be like, you know, Bugs and Daffy would get pissed off at Hitler or something. You know, and I was like, wow, okay. It was pretty cool. Yeah, those are the good old days. But they were all the good old days. These are the good old days, too, in case you didn't know. Yes, just wait a while. Favorite dessert.
Apple pie.
Oh, and what's your favorite dessert? Apple pie. Now Mickey Mouse Funhouse. I don't think they're on yet. We've got like 40 some more to go. And then there's two things that they don't have names for. So you know, a lot of times you record stuff and then they'll name it. They'll figure out the name later. But yeah, still going. You know. Moving away. No, not right now. I'm not working on anything. And I'll keep you posted. I promise. You'll know. You know, we'd be sitting around playing Monopoly while I was coming up. Like I said, you know, the original came out when I was a kid. And it would be sitting playing Monopoly, and I would just, you know, and I would say, I believe I'm in my park place. You know, and I'm going to go over there to the Reading Railroad, you know, and just be a ticker. And so I was just doing it, you know, just like, you know, cuz, you know. Well, I mean, I would probably do Bugs Bunny too. Actually, I didn't, but anyway. You know, I would just sit around doing it, and I would be doing voices and